Part 2. Verdant Wind. Blue Sea Moon. The City Without Light. Immediately following Edelgard's defeat, the Alliance Army discovers the existence of another adversary, a group operating behind the scenes within the Empire. Claude suspects that if the true enemy is left unchecked, disaster will befall Fodlan, and so he cuts short the celebration and the troops head for Shambhala, where this foe resides.
What's going on? You didn't want to train? I guess that's fine. Ah, oh yeah, I can tell this is a good one. Come on, hand it over. Thanks. Delicious. Huh? Huh? I get it now. Yeah. Whoa. Who was that guy? You don't know who I'm talking about? The suspicious guy who killed himself. Oh, great! Huh? I'm not good at staying still for too long. Maybe I can get some squats in. Professor, I know my arms aren't very long, but they sure are muscular. Thanks for this, Professor. Don't you want to get some exercise, though? Come on, let's go train! Do you have a minute, Professor? I gotta talk to you. I've been thinking a lot about those brigands with the scorpion tattoos, and I realized something. I mean, I'll feel better if I get this off my chest, right? Okay, listen. I think I can't deny who I am. I know you were right 5 years ago when you told me not to chase after that suspicious guy. But I still can't get over the possibility that he might have hurt those kids. I would have regretted not stopping him for the rest of my life. There's no way I could forgive myself. It sounds awful to say, but the safety of those kids is more important to me than the nights we lost. I'm sorry, Professor, but I can't promise that I won't disobey your orders in the future. I know. It's too big a risk to keep me around. I won't cause a fuss. I'll just pack my bags and... Wait, what? I guess so. You're really okay with me sticking around? Even if I might not always follow orders, people could get hurt if you let me keep doing things my way. Just like that? I almost can't believe it. I really struggled to come to this decision, you know. I want to stand by your side, but I won't stop standing up for what I believe in. I know I might cause trouble for everyone, but I just... You know, I give up. I've got nothing else to say. I should have just kept my mouth shut. Yeah, I know. Thanks, Professor. Thanks for accepting me for who I am. I'm glad I get to keep fighting by your side. I just don't get it.
What is it, Claude?
Those javelins of light. They were trying to use it to kill us at Fort Mercius, right? But then why not drop it on Garrig Mach? They must have known for a while that we were here.
It is not that they chose to refrain, but rather that they were unable to do so.
Rhea, how are you feeling?
I am well enough. I cannot afford to rest while Fodlan is in danger.
What do you mean when you say they couldn't drop a javelin of light here?
Once, a very long time ago, a massive ball of light fell upon this monastery. However, that light mysteriously changed course in mid-air and landed in Aelel instead.
Aelel, the Valley of Torment. So that's what the wreckage of those javelins of light looks like.
The Holy Tomb is not only the location of the progenitor god's eternal slumber, but also a sacred vessel for a power that repels evil. Supposedly, the progenitor god built the Holy Tomb herself to protect her children from the evil light.
So the children of the goddess gathered in Xanadu because of its proximity to the monastery? But we've fought at distant locations many times.
Despite that, the javelins of light only fell on Fort Mercius.
In his letter, Hubert said that he detected their magic when the fort fell. In other words, because they used a javelin of light, Hubert was able to pinpoint the location of their base.
So they didn't use it before then because they didn't want us to know where their base is?
In any case, those javelins of light must be something they can't just use whenever they want. And they finally decided to use one at Mercius, where they were sure they'd be able to finish us off. It's only thanks to the whims of the Death Knight that we escaped with our lives. And no javelins of light have fallen since then.
It's possible that the enemy hasn't yet realized that we've learned the location of their base.
If so, their guard may be down, which makes this the perfect time for a surprise attack.
I will accompany you.
What? No! That would be far too dangerous. Your long confinement weakened you greatly, did it not?
Those people have opposed us since ancient times. I wish to learn the truth about them for myself.
I understand. I will not stop you, but please take care not to overexert yourself.
We don't know exactly what we're up against here, but having you around is very reassuring, Rhea. Let's prepare to strike at Shambhala before they make their next move.
I did it.
Is something troubling you, Ingrid?
Oh, Sedith. You seem to have caught me when I thought nobody was around.
Perhaps I can help, if you would like to share.
I wouldn't want to bother you with my trivialities.
I will not pry, of course. But if you keep it to yourself, no one will be able to help you.
That's true. It's regarding my father.
Count Galatea. I have met him once or twice.
Yes, that's him. He and I have parted ways now. House Galatea was financially unstable for a long time. We were hardly able to support our soldiers and their steeds. My father had hopes that with my crest, I'd be married into a noble family, and that House Galatea's financial troubles would be a thing of the past.
Ah, I see. And the other house would benefit from the addition of your crest-bearing blood.
That was certainly the idea, but I broke ties with them. I do wonder how they are doing back home.
It seems to me you have suffered much for the misfortune of being born with a crest.
I beg your pardon?
I know crests are highly valued, but they are also a burden. My feelings are mixed.
You truly think so? But you're so devoted to the goddess. I'm surprised to hear you say such a thing.
Perhaps one day I will expound upon my opinion of crests in greater detail with you. For now, let it suffice to say that whether or not you bear one is secondary to your identity. You are a person, first and foremost. And you should be permitted to grow as a person, crest or not.
I agree. Thank you for listening.
If you ever wish to discuss this again, consider me available whenever you please.
Thank you so much.
This war might be over, but not war in general. Human beings thrive on conflict. We can't get enough of it. I don't know when, but you know someday another war will begin. Yeah, but the fight is still worth it. War may always come back, but so will peace. And peace is what we fight for.
I thought that after the Empire fell, the boar might finally be avenged. But something dark is certainly lurking in the shadows. An organization behind the Empire. We'll have to take care of them if the boar... if Dimitri is to rest in peace.
Gone, maybe Fodlan will finally find some peace. That's all well and good, but, she was also the one to put my father under house arrest. So now he's been released and he's taken charge of House Varley. I can't handle it! I can't deal with him! Please, you have to do something! Thank you so much! Finally, that awful war is over. Everyone lost something, and everyone had to make sacrifices. But maybe we can put a stop to all of this pain and loss now. Let's hurry to Shambhala, Professor. We have to defeat them if we ever want to see a world without war.
Right. Thank you.
Is it really prudent to bring Lady Rhea on our upcoming expedition? It would be best not to have her doing anything strenuous, considering how long she was confined. There are still many in Fodlan who are seeking Lady Rhea's salvation. For their sake, we cannot put her in harm's way.
Shambhala, it was called, right? Scary that it's so close to the House Goneril territories. Who'd have thought all those creeps were living right under my nose? I was hoping my big brother would help us in this next battle. But he says that I can represent House Goneril without his help, that I have it in me. I'm glad he recognizes that I have some ability. Still, I wish he wasn't leaving it all to me.
I thought that taking the Empire's capital would bring an end to this war. How naive of me. I'll have to write to my family and tell them I'll be gone a while longer.
Oh.
Greetings, Professor. Nothing to report. I can hardly believe you managed to handle the capital city like that. Everyone did sterling work. I really thought we'd know peace after that battle. But we're not quite there yet, huh?
Hello there. This one, yes? This one, yes? I thank you. Return soon, please.
Pardon me.
We crushed the Empire at long last. But there's no time to bask in our victory. We must prepare for the coming battle. We knew there was a secret group behind the Imperial Army all this time. Now we have a chance to make the first move against them. We have Hubert to thank for that. It's also thanks to him that we were able to rescue Rhea. I still have plenty of questions I'd like to ask her. Sadly, I agree. After we return from the next battle, we'll ask her all of our burning questions. Rhea's the only one who gets a break, though. Everyone else had better start preparing for battle.
We won against the Imperial Army! I still can't believe it, but I guess we still have some enemies left. I'm not well informed, but I have plenty of fighting spirit. How about...
Count Burgles, the Minister of Military Affairs, was applying pressure in the West, but he surrendered after the Empire fell. Cornelia of the Fargus Dukedom seems to have disappeared from the palace, and rather swiftly. They must have realized that the revival of the Old Kingdom was a real threat.
A mysterious power threatening the very future of Fodlan? Certainly we cannot give it leeway. In comparison to this, the internal power struggles in the Alliance are utterly trivial.
There is simply no option but victory. The alternative is unthinkable. Perhaps I will have the opportunity to strike the decisive blow on the enemy commander. Oh, that would secure my place in history for certain. This is lovely. Oh my, this is lovely.
Okay.
You did it. I never thought I'd live to see the day that the Empire was conquered. I thought that would put an end to the war. But I hear there are still hostile forces to contend with. I hope you'll be able to put an end to this conflict and found a new Fodlan in which the free market can thrive.
I have a thought. You've done it. You did it. You crushed the Empire and rescued Lady Rhea. I'm sure the captain is proud of you right now. As am I, of course. I'm as proud as if I'd done it myself. Sorry, I didn't mean to overdo it. We still have to deal with Monica's group, those who killed the captain. We'll knock them down so hard that they can't get back up.
I love to cook. What are we making today? That's so. I have a lot of experience in the kitchen. I can make just about anything. Wow.
This dish. It was my father's favorite.
This is my most favorite dish of all. I love it almost as much as Crestology itself.
Wake up, eat, train, eat, train, eat, sleep. We gotta prepare for the assault. But that hasn't changed my routine. All that training
and eating
I do is for the sake of Fodlan. Gotta stay strong
and fed
to keep it safe.
This experience is critical.
The moment we defeat 80, the nobles cozy up to the Alliance and Church. That lot really does think only of themselves and no one else. But then there's Count Burgles. He used to be Minister of Military Affairs. He sacrificed his own life so that all the soldiers and officers who fought could be given quarter. When I heard that, I don't know, that simple act of humanity, I couldn't help it. Burst into tears. You know Count Burgles is Caspar's father, right? I can't even imagine how Caspar must feel about it.
Hello there!
How's this?
We saved Rhea and the Empire has crumbled. The kingdom may as well be finished too. The reasons for me to remain in Fodlan are fading. Of course. I've come this far. May as well see it through to the end.
professor!
Hello there.
I thought the war would end with Edelgard's defeat, but that wasn't the case. This may be premature, but I'm feeling a little relieved. I have to consider what I'll do with myself, and where I'll go when this war is finally over. I don't have an answer yet. Let's make sure the next battle puts an end to this war. That way, we can all move forward.
So Lady Rhea was all right after all. Well done bringing her back safely. Finally, us true believers may breathe easy again. Simply magnificent. Hmm? You're saying the fight isn't over yet?
Right.
The folks we're fighting next aren't normal humans, are they? It's that group who caused the Javelin of Light to fall, right? It just doesn't seem like something a human is capable of. I'm not prone to flinching, but I don't feel great about any of this.
Okay.
A mysterious organization, slithering in the dark of Fodlan, like something out of a midnight tale. It appears these fiends have infiltrated the deepest corners of the Empire. After the fall of Enbar, they've remained well concealed. That said, I would keep an eye on Edelgard's uncle, Lord Arendelle. Something about him sits ill with me.
Dedue saw to it that Edelgard was destroyed before he departed. His expression, once his mission was over, was a bit lonely. I don't know where he went off to after that. Maybe he returned home to Dusker.
Monica's people, aren't they? The ones who killed Captain Geralt. Then this is my real opportunity for revenge. There's no way I can back down from this one. No, I'm okay. Actually, I'm eager to get out there and fight. This is what I've been training for.
We've all heard the legend of Nemesis, the King of Liberation. But now Lady Rhea is saying Nemesis was just some kind of thief. Those two descriptions are totally at odds. Which version's correct? I don't know what to think, but I guess that's the nature of history. I wonder what the generations that come after us will say about the battle we're about to fight.
Oh. I heard that Lady Rhea's back. But why hasn't she shown herself to everyone yet? Oh, she's convalescing. Fair enough. She was in captivity for a long time. I pray that she feels better soon.
The thing is, we finally got Lady Rhea back from the Empire and fulfilled our mission. I wish we could afford for her to have a good long rest, but that just isn't possible.
Hey, you.
Thank you. Hmm.
considered... As history proves, everything comes to an end eventually. I knew that all along, but it still came as a surprise. Those who slither in the dark. It's all so fascinating and strange. They must certainly have a long history of their own. And when they fall, that will come quickly too, don't you think? That almost sounded like a prophecy there. Am I spooking you yet?
Dead. My father's dead. I'm okay, though. Really. I was ready for it. He was a general in the Imperial Army, after all. Minister of Military Affairs. He gave his own life so the Empire's soldiers wouldn't have to lose theirs. That's a fight that only he could take on. He was such a tough guy. This whole time, I fought side by side with you and Claude. But did I ever get any stronger? Will I ever be as strong as my father?
Wow. Lady Rhea still seems weak, but at least she's safe now. I'm praying that she'll be well as soon as possible. Goddess, I beg you, protect Lady Rhea.
Listen.
We have succeeded in rescuing Lady Rhea, but Seteth's countenance remains clouded. When will peaceful days return to this monastery? That time feels so distant.
Hey!
Professor, fighting against enemies whose true nature is unknown is honestly really scary. Still, if there's a force in this world that clearly means us harm, we have no choice but to fight back. With our own hands, we'll safeguard Fodlan's future.
Here's a thought.
The Empire has broken in smithereens. Now it is possible for me to go back to Bridget, but... I cannot choose that choice. The time is still too soon for that. We must be stopping the evil for everyone in Fodlan. We will be fighting until the end of it.
Our next opponent is an ally of Solon. Do you remember what Solon called us? That's right. He called us beasts. Meanwhile, he refers to himself as the savior. Who exactly is he saving?
Listen.
The history of the Empire spans 1,185 years. And just like that, it ends. But the Hressfeld legacy could live on. When Edelgard assumed power, there were no other rightful heirs. She said that whoever takes the throne next should do so by virtue of merit, not blood. And she truly meant what she said. At any rate, I feel that a huge hole has opened up in my heart. Who knows if it can ever be filled?
Right.
Those who slither in the dark. It seems we'll finally discover their true form. I get the sense that they're in league with the mages who experimented on me as a child. I wouldn't be surprised if Edelgard was subjected to them too. There's no telling what their true motives are. But whatever their motives, what they have done is unforgivable. They must be exterminated.
Rhea is unharmed. My brother continues to worry about her, however. Of course, I am worried myself. I cannot imagine being in that situation while in such a state. She should just leave things to you and Claude and get the rest she needs.
Rescued Lady Rhea. I can hardly express my joy. But now we know about a new foe who intends to bring her harm. In time, we'll realize the peaceful world that Lady Rhea has always hoped for. I'll have to keep that in mind when I'm fighting.
Professor.
Lady Rhea's back! Lady Rhea's back! I'm so happy!
But things aren't gonna be like they used to be anytime soon, are they? There's still folks out there that want us all dead, and Lady Rhea still hasn't regained her strength yet. Speaking of which, Professor, please don't ask too much of her right now, okay?
Rhea is sleeping right now. If it is not absolutely urgent, please do not disturb her rest. The long confinement took its toll on her health. Truthfully, she is in no shape to be exerting herself at all, to say nothing of a military expedition. To make matters worse, we are now facing a very old enemy. One that has conspired against us since time out of mind. Please proceed with caution. I have a bad feeling.
Professor, most of the opera company fled, but they're back in the capital now. I don't know if everyone survived, but it looks like they should be able to mount a revival. They even asked if I'd consider making a return to the stage someday. I suspect I may refuse, though. We're at the dawn of something new. No reason to look backwards, eh?
Training? Is this for me? It's so nice! Is this for me?
Yet.
Yeah.
It's done. No time to slow down. Nothing to get excited about. Continue with the praises.
Thank you. Professor, may I ask you a question? Splendid!
With you on my side, this'll be a cakewalk.
Okay, I'll try real hard. We didn't do too bad, did we?
Growth sustains me.
This song reaches the goddess's ears.
Me. Something appears to be wrong with my throat.
I am pleased that you invited me. I am ever so grateful. So soothing. I was born in Enbar, though I have lived in remote lands far away at times. Today. Are you feeling all right? Have some, Professor. Ever since your hair shifted to look more like mine, I feel so much closer to you. That tea was very delicious. Please take care, Professor.
This is delicious! My absolute favorite!
I like this dish. It was my father's favorite.
I can cook food, but not anything you'd call cuisine. I just think it's all the same once it's in your stomach, so why overdo it with the cooking, right? Oh, really?
Professor! All that treat?
I have a thought that we still will not.
A mysterious.
Wow.
Oh.
Welcome. Is that the one? Thanks a bunch. Come back soon.
Oh.
I thought this. I have. I don't. Let's make. True. Then this is. Wow, this is great. Wow. I'll keep my voice down. Don't want people thinking I'm vying for attention. But how loud is too loud?
Am I doing all right? I hope I'm not too off.
They're still for their sake.
I'm glad. I love it! Thank you so much! I love it!
Professor,
those. Yet I would. There's no, but whatever.
For me? I love it! For me?
Professor!
But we must be.
Professor.
Wow.
We rest, but in time.
Professor. Well.
Oh. Rhea is belonged to Megma. Please proceed.
No time to slow down. You lost that one. It's done. I will not die yet.
You really think I'm that great?
Don't stop. I think I've got the idea. Oh, I'll get the next one too. I'm glad I put in some effort, for once. I didn't even know I cared this much. No. Nothing to get excited about.
Let's not exaggerate. Not.
No need to discontinue with the praises.
Thank you.
Professor!
We did a fine job.
I'll do my best with this.
I passed.
There. This one, yes? I thank you. Return soon, please.
Professor!
I love to cook. What are we making today? That's so. I have a lot of experience in the kitchen. I can make just about anything. Wow.
Eating delicious food really takes my worries away.
I like this dish. It was my father's favorite.
Professor! All that training? Is this for me? Is this for me?
Come to think of it.
So, that lot, but then he said, when I heard, you know, Count.
I'm getting the hang of this.
Waste will not.
True. Then this is my. Wow. Wow. No time to slow down. I will not die yet. It's done. Keep my voice down. Don't want people thinking I'm vying for attention. But how loud is too loud?
Ah, it feels good to sing nice and loud. Fill my chest up with sound.
Could be.
They're still for their sake.
Shampoo. I was, but he, I'm glad. I'll.
Professor!
But we must be...
Professor!
Wow. We read but in time.
Professor! Could I trouble you?
I think I am so... My breath, of course, she should... I shall take it! Wow! I am delighted! What is this? I shall take it!
But there's speaking of... This is for me?
Thanks.
Thanks, Professor. Thanks, Professor.
Rhea is the long to make my... Please proceed.
Oh. You shouldn't have.
I accept.
This is wonderful.
I accept.
Don't stop. Keep it coming. I'm glad I put in some effort, for once. Could be useful. Let's see it in action. Get excited about.
Oh, thanks, Professor. That's really nice of you to say.
Thank you.
This may seem a bit sudden, but I want to thank you, Professor. That is, for letting me live my life the way I want. I've noticed you've been giving me fewer of those soul-revealing gazes lately. I appreciate you making an effort to not trouble yourself over who I spend my time with. Well, of course. Did you think I wouldn't notice? It's kind of sweet in its own way. Professor, may I tell you a story about when I was younger? I was an orphan, living in the back alleys of Enbar, until one day I was overheard singing. That was when my new life began. I was suddenly a songstress in the Mittelfranc Opera Company. Performers, nobility. I met so many people. But none of them ever really knew me. I was just some young, pretty girl who could sing. A spectacle to be admired. Even though everyone praised my looks and my voice and they showered me with gifts, I knew one day I'd be old. My looks would fade, my voice would change. I wouldn't sound the same. And I started to wonder, when I did get old, what would I have left? I'd be old, alone, and back on the streets of the capital, right where I'd started. You can never be certain about what the future will bring. I never had much to begin with in life, and I worry that one day I'll be that way again. That's why I keep searching for someone who will love me. Someone unaware of the songstress, who can love a girl that used to be scared and alone on the streets of the capital. I wonder if such a strange person can even exist.
I'm happy to have this time with you. Thanks. The taste of relaxation. Oh? Of course. Right. Of course. Right. Blast. I'm afraid I've stayed too long. Thanks for the tea. Let's plan to do this again sometime.
With you on my side, this'll be a cakewalk. Any excuse to spend time with you. Look, Professor, not too shabby, right?
Can I use this off the battlefield?
Let's put this to the test.
Growth sustains me.
I see how this works.
Is this what success feels like?
I've really gotten the hang of this.
Thank you.
done. It's done. I will not die yet. I've got no time for mercy. I will not die yet.
I thought, but we'll have.
Oh, at last! A chance to show off my cooking skills. There. Looks tasty, doesn't it?
Needs a little more salt.
Definitely.
This dish. It was my father's favorite.
That looks delicious. Goddess, forgive me. I've just got to indulge.
I have a thought. This waste will not.
Let's make.
Singing's okay, but I should really have a cute dance to go along with it.
Professor, let me sing for you. Do you not like my voice? It would make a Pegasus dance with joy.
Could be. They're still for their sake.
Professor!
But we must be.
Professor!
Wow. We rest but in time.
Professor!
Lady Ray, but they're speaking of...
Ray, along to make me please proceed. Rhea, along to make me please proceed. I must thank you. I appreciate the invitation. Just the way I like it. We must have similar tastes. I must thank you. I feel at ease. Yes. I concur. What? Ah. What? When my own thoughts grow tiresome, I go fishing. You should join me sometime.
Yes.
What? This is wonderful.
What?
Our similar hair and eye colors are proof we share common ancestry. I enjoy casual conversation once in a while. I should get back to work. Thank you for the tea. Yes.
Professor!
Hey, welcome! Come again.
Hello there. This one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. Return soon, please.
Hey, welcome. You have a pleasure doing business with you. Come again.
Hello. Will this one do? It's all yours. Take it. Tell your friends.
Welcome. Is that the one? Come back soon.
Hello there.
This one, yes.
I thank this one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. Return soon, please.
Professor!
Welcome. This one?
Thank you.
This one?
Thank you. Please come again.
What do you require? Farewell.
Hey there. Is this it? There you go. Is this it? There you go. Come back anytime.
Hello there. This one, yes? I thank you. Return soon, please.
Hey there. Is this it? There you go. 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 Come back anytime.
Oh, hey, Professor. Actually, I ran into that thief while I was shopping just now. Maybe you don't remember. It's been quite a while. The man who stole the book from that market stall. I saw him on the street with his kid. They were both so grateful. It's a really nice feeling. Yeah. But it did seem like they were still having trouble getting by. I guess what you said to me back then was right. My actions didn't really solve the problem. I can't help everyone, no matter how much I try. If I had the money or power, maybe. but I don't. You know, a long time ago, Lenato said nearly the same thing to me. I think it was when I tried to look after the horses all on my own. I really messed that up. He said, "You're not quite ready for this yet, but there's no need to rush. I know I can't help very many people right now, but I think doing what I can for those I see in front of me is still worthwhile. I have to believe that, at least." Thanks. That's reassuring to hear. What about you, Professor? Has anything been troubling you lately? I'd be happy to help, as long as it's not looking after horses. You might not want to trust me with that. Hey, don't be that way. There's gotta be something. It doesn't have to be serious. I genuinely enjoy helping people. It's a great feeling making someone smile. So if there's anything I can do for you, I want to do it, because I care about you. You think so? It's just what anyone would do, really. So what'll it be? How can I help? Of course! I'd be glad to cook with you.
My future is bright.
Guess I did it!
Relying on a map entrusted to them by Hubert, The Alliance Army sets their sights on the base belonging to those who slither in the dark. Beyond its entrance, they are met by a sprawling underground city.
Incredible. Who knew that there was such a vast space beneath the ground?
It's like an underground city. I've never seen buildings like these before.
It's like an ancient ruin, but not just because of its appearance.
I don't recall ever seeing architecture like this.
It is magnificent in a sense, but I could hardly call it beautiful. Even the air feels stagnant.
In any case, it seems like we need to go deeper. Let's look around and see if we can find some stairs.
No. It is simply, we must defeat those who slither in the dark, no matter what happens. But if my conjecture is correct, the one who they will wish to kill the most is you, dear child. They are aware that you can use the sword of the Creator. Your body houses the same power they once bestowed upon Nemesis. That is why I fear for you. Perhaps. Please forgive my errant thoughts. Once this battle is over, I will explain everything. I will tell you all I know about who you really are.
I never pictured this for myself. Hmm.
thousands of years, we have existed underground, living on only that we might someday see our vengeance realized. Here and now, that vengeance is finally within our grasp. There is but one thing left to do. Destroy them! Damn those who stand with that arrogant goddess to oblivion, away from the world of the living! Now is the time. Remove the binding spell of Titanus. Let their metal bodies be drenched in blood!
Hey, what are those big things?
Demonic beasts? No, I think not. They appear to have no will of their own. Someone must be controlling them.
Initiate all that remain. We must advance our preparations.
At the ready.
Do my best. My blood compels me. Now there's a way forward.
Let's go. Stronger. Seems I've improved again.
Let's make this quick.
Shall we?
My orders? Make a difference?
Leave it to me.
What's my strategy?
Steady now.
I'll defeat you.
No mercy.
Guide me well.
Still alive. I've found strength in adversity. Appreciate that.
No chance.
No time to slow down. Apologies. Sorry, but it's you or me.
Make a difference? Work to be done.
That's an embarrassment.
Increase output gradually, depending on the amount of magical energy charged. I don't care if we destroy Shambhala, so long as our goals are fulfilled.
Too easy.
Too slow!
Destiny unfurls. Had I room to grow?
Enemies are my enemies.
Thank you.
Stronger, haven't I?
Shall we?
Leave it to me.
What's my strategy? Another victory.
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
At the ready. Let's go.
Let's make this quick. You lost that one.
Shall we?
Sorry. Guide me well.
Onward.
Appreciate it.
Steady now.
I'll show you.
For the future of Bodland.
My orders?
Apologies.
It won't be in vain.
No time to slow down. I will keep making progress.
You're really going for it.
Those big things have gone to sleep on us. That'll make moving around a lot easier. A dead end? Or perhaps... No, if we worry about every little detail, we won't get anywhere.
That helps. I've gotten stronger.
I don't care if it's not finished. Forcibly increase Viscom's output.
He seems to be issuing orders to that facility. If we destroy it, perhaps that will stop those weapons.
I must pull through.
Thanks.
My skills are rising to my status.
Gotten stronger, haven't I?
Still alive.
For now, I'll revel in my achievement. Those awful weapons have been stopped. They were being controlled from that facility.
You!
That is the leader of those who slither in the dark. We must go after him with all of our might! I'll make you proud, Gerald!
Make a difference? Exemplary.
No time for mercy.
You knew it would end as such.
Appreciate it.
What's my strategy?
Strong survive.
Don't try me!
Won't allow it.
Huh.
picture.
I wasn't about to let you go.
Just a scratch. Thank you. I don't want to die here.
I could do.
Fitting outcome.
This is our chance.
Judgment is past!
That is all.
That helps.
I don't want to die here.
I'll do my best. Onward.
Steady now.
What's my strategy?
Leave it to me.
Guide me well.
My orders?
Shall we? Let's make this quick.
Shall we?
Apologies.
At the ready.
Leave it to me.
What's my strategy?
Guide me well.
Onward.
My orders?
I'll do my best.
Shall we?
Steady now. At the ready.
Shall we? Let's make this quick.
I don't want to die here. Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
Bladebreaker taught me well.
Growing stronger suits me.
You're amazing.
Thank you.
defeat you!
Kid? I took care of it. I want to do my part.
Can't afford to slack off. Ever so grateful.
It is laughable that base animals such as you would bear fangs at the likes of us.
I may be a base animal, but I have strong allies. Do you think you can beat Teach and the Sword of the Creator?
The Sword of the Creator? The blade given to Nemesis? Who do you really think is superior?
There's a big difference between the living and the dead. The fate of the future lies in the hands of the living.
Lead, now!
Hold a grudge if you must.
Your eyes, hair, ears, and blood. We remember it all. We remember how you ruined us. How you stole our light and condemned us to eternal darkness. Now, suffer the wrath of the Agarthans!
You shall not survive!
Onward.
I don't want to die here.
That helps. Let's make this quick.
You're nothing but animals, performing tricks in the hopes of pleasing the goddess. You will never see the sunlight again!
You will regret this!
Guide me well.
Judgment is past!
Destiny unfurls.
I am so impressed.
I don't want to die here.
What's my strategy?
So you have shown yourself, Felstar. Or should I say, Sophis? I will spill every drop of blood in your body to fulfill the long-standing goal of the Agarthans. Ha!
Oh! Yep! Predictable.
Not my best. I'm getting the hang of this.
You're nothing but animals, performing tricks in the hopes of pleasing the goddess. You will never see the sunlight again!
I've gotten stronger, haven't I? Hang in there, Lady Rhea.
Get her to her room, quickly!
That's a serious injury. It's a miracle that she's even alive right now. I'll do what I can, but...
Goddess, please save Lady Rhea. All we can do now is pray.
Remember when this place was taken 5 years ago and a pure white beast appeared on the battlefield? I only caught a glimpse of it, but I didn't understand where it came from. There were rumors that the goddess sent it to protect the monastery. But now I know better. That beast was Rhea. Did you know Rhea's true identity? I once showed you a picture of a creature known as the Immaculate One. Sedith confiscated it, saying it must have been one of Tomas's personal possessions. The beast that appeared back then looked just like it. So Rhea is the Immaculate One. The book said that it was a servant of the goddess, but wouldn't it make sense if beasts like that are actually children of the goddess? Rhea is in a grim state right now. It's possible she may not make it, but we have things we must ask her about. Once things calm down a little, let's go and see Rhea. Together. The truth can't be delayed any longer.